Sneha, and you are watching my channel Book Junction. So it was raining heavily that day and I thought that I should sit down and do some reading. And if you have read any of my other vlogs, then you would know that I always sit down with a glass of juice when I'm reading. So I thought this time I will make something exceptionally healthy, as the last book that I read was all about healing. So that's why I am making beetroot juice this time, and it's not that bad, but it is so healing and it is just so good for us. So I just took two beetroots and I cut them into small pieces, and I've added a little bit of water and only one small spoon of sugar, because if we add too much of sugar then there's no point. So this is how it looks. And then just use your mixture grinder, or if you have a blender then also it's okay. And this is how it looks after grinding it. Then I just took a sieve, which you cannot see over here, but I took a sieve, and then I was just putting the mixture on that, and you can see the juice pour itself. I mean, just look at the color of the juice. This is like so beautiful dark maroon, and you know, the moment you see it, it looks that it has so much goodness, and that when you will drink it, it will just heal you from inside. Then I added a little bit of lemon juice, because honestly I'm not a big fan of the way beetroot smells. So the lemon juice, you know, covered for that foul smell, and it started smelling really good after adding the lemon juice. Alright, so now let's talk about the book that I'm going to read. So I started the book The Fountains of Silence by Ruta Sepetys a day back, and the day I started it, I finished 70% of the book. That's how unputdownable the book is. And in this video, you will see me read the rest of the book. And I heard a lot about Ruta Sepetys, that she is, you know, like the master of historical fiction. And this book is also historical fiction. It's based on Spain. Now, this book is huge. When you see the size of this book, you can see that it's a big book. Like, it's a huge book. It's not only thick, but it's, you know, even the length of the book is pretty big. And when I picked up for the first time, I was actually overwhelmed. I thought whether I will be able to finish it, you know. But the day I picked the book, I read 70% of the book. That's how amazing the story is, and that's why I was really excited to make this video and read the rest of the book in front of you. Alright, so now let me just fill you up about the story of the book. So the story of The Fountains of Silence is based on 1957 Madrid, when Spain was under the fascist dictatorship of General Francisco Franco. So during that time, Spain was hiding a lot of dark secrets, and you will get to know about a couple of them that Ruta Sepetys has discussed in the book. Now I feel like the book is well researched. Like, the way she has put across all those things, I think it's it is commendable the way she has done it. So for that, I give her, you know, all the stars of the world, because I really loved it. And, you know, we have all read about Hitler and Mussolini, but we have not read a lot of books on Spain's history and about General Francisco Franco. So for that, this book is actually very important. Now, during that time, a lot of tourists used to flood Spain, and from outside everything used to look good, that Spain is reviving, their economy is reviving, but their people were under a lot of pressure, because obviously it was a dictatorship government, there was no democracy, so the people were under a huge pressure. Now, the protagonists of this book are Anna and Daniel Matheson. Now, Daniel is a tourist. He is an American. He is called an Americano in the book. And he has come to Spain, Madrid to, you know, travel. He has come as a tourist. And Anna is the housekeeper in the hotel where Daniel is staying. Now, there is an instant connection between Anna and Daniel. The moment they meet, the moment they talk, there is something that is just perfect. So obviously it's a love story, but the thing is that Anna and Daniel's relationship or their friendship is a way so that Daniel can capture the story of Spain through his lenses, as he wants to be a photojournalist, and he roams around Spain with Anna and clicks all these pictures to show the world the story of Spain, and that's how we get to learn a lot about Spain as well. Honestly speaking, I loved the book to bits, like from the very first page to the very end. I loved it thoroughly, and I feel like it is such a wholesome book. You also get to know so much, and you also get to read such lovely characters. And after finishing the book, I was just going through this existential dread, because the book was over and I wanted to hug the book for the longest, because I didn't want it to let go. And oh my god, it's, I think, pretty apparent with the way I'm sounding right now. So anyway, if you like this video, then definitely like, share and subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon so you are notified with all the updates, and I'll see you in my next video. Until then, bye bye.